This represents what my father brought me up on history of Yankees, on the great players who played in this stadium and turned this franchise into what it is today, is the greatest franchise in the world. And there's nothing else like it in any ballpark or any stadium. There's nothing else like this in sports.
Hello there, I'm Johnny Damon of the New York Yankees.
Joining me now is a historic piece of Yankees in the Bronx, Freddy. Now, Freddy walks through the crowd at just about every single game and lets people bang on the victory banger here. Now, Freddy, let's hear that. Now, those of you that know anything about Yankees history, you know that sound, and you know this face. And I'm blessed today to be talking to Freddy. Freddy, how you doing today?
Wonderful. And you know, if you don't hear this sign, that means I'm not here.
That's right. I know it. You've been here for a long time. Freddy, how long have you been doing this?
This is 18th year now. I retired from work in 1988, and that's when I started it all.
And I love it because they let you roam around pretty much freely in there and do your thing, huh?
Well, that's the whole thing. If I can get you fans to make enough noise, maybe the Yankees will respond with a win.
And they do have their shares of win, don't they?
So far, they're doing pretty fair this year. I'd like to see the pitching improve, though.
Yeah, it does need a little improvement, but I think it's going to get better as the year goes on.
Yeah, well, it looks that way. And as long as the weather is fairly decent and the boys start hitting that ball, we'll be all right.
You know what I think, Freddie? I think this is number 27 coming up this year. That's what I think.
Well, it should be from your voice up to the big guy up there.
Hey, Freddy, I want to thank you for taking the time to talk to us.
Oh, it's been my pleasure. I love when you folks interview me. I'm a little bit of a ham anyway.
Thanks, Freddy. Freddy, God bless, and we'll see you soon.
All right, we'll do. Let's go, Yankees.
Thank you, Freddy. Oh, God bless. Thank you. And here we are, folks. We got some of the best fans. No, we have the best fans in all of the world, right? Am I right? All right, before I get your names, who's the best baseball team ever to step foot on this planet?
New York Yankees!
All right, I'm with you there. What's your name, young man?
Cody.
Cody, all right.
Brandon.
You got these guys here? Cody? Brandon?
Yeah. Yeah.
James.
James?
Gene.
Gene. Gene, the dance machine.
Christian.
Chris?
Jordan.
Oh, yes. Jordan.
Caitlin.
Caitlin.
Kevin.
Kevin. I'm going to sneak around this way.
Kevin.
Kevin. Kevin and Kevin,
Kevin,
right?
With the Yankee tattoo.
I love it.
Joe.
Tell him your name.
That's Mike.
Mikey.
Debbie.
George.
George.
Jen.
Jen. Did I miss anybody? Once again, on the count of three. Tell us again.
Caitlin,
all right. And on count of three, I want you to tell me who the best baseball team ever known to man. Right? One, two, three.
The Yankees!
Okay, we're standing outside the stands, the ever-famous stands with Joe. Joe, tell us, how long have you been involved with this kind of thing here?
This started about 15 minutes after the Red Sox won in 04. Right. Didn't take long.
I hear you. All right. Now, have you been going in watching the games here at as a young man or what?
I grew up not far from the stadium, so I used to come down back, I think 76 was my first game. I was 6 years old. Shortly after that, there was a couple World Series years in there. And then growing up here, coming down to the stadium was just a great way to spend the day.
This is the place that I like to be the most, watching baseball. What about yourself?
I couldn't imagine being any place else for baseball. I mean, the Bronx is, especially in the fall, there's no place like being in the Bronx for a baseball game.
All right, now, 26 World Series to 6-1 in like the last 100 years. I mean, how do they even think that they can be mentioned in the same universe?
Well, you know, you talk about them enough, and they start to feel like they belong, I guess. I mean, the truth is, you know, we beat up on them long enough, everybody thinks we're part of a team. But, no, the rivalry is such that, who knows? I mean, they get, they've done well. They give us a run for our money once in a while, but for the most part, 86, you know, 26-6 is not much to talk about.
That's right. That kind of says it all, doesn't it?
Yeah, it really does. It really does.
Joe, thank you for taking the time, my friend.
Junior, thanks a lot.
We'll be back to see you again.
All right. Have a great year. Talk to you soon.
All right. Hey, joining me now is someone that's out here, and he knows his Yankee stuff. As a matter of fact, he's selling some Yankee stuff, and he knows about baseball. Vinny, how you doing, buddy?
Doing good tonight. How you doing?
All right. All right. Listen, you got to tell these people back at home in Boston, who's the winningest team in history? I mean, I think they know, but they need to be reminded.
You know, 27 times. How many, you know, I can't tell you any more than that. 26-6.
That's right.
26 times, you know, 26-time world champion going for number 27 this year. It's all Yankees all the time.
I hear that. You know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking 27 is going to happen this year.
This is definitely our year. You know, we got the secret weapon, Johnny Damon, stolen from you guys up there. And, you know, he's going to do the damage here.
I hear you. Well, I think it's the right time. It's the right year for our owner, George Steinbrenner, the best owner in all of sports. What do you think?
Oh, definitely. You know, he cares about the team, puts the money back in, invests in the team and the players, and always puts a great product out on the field.
Vinny, thanks for your time, brother.
Man, thank you very much.
All right, take
enjoy.
Care.
With me now, two gentlemen that own this van. This is Ray, am I right?
Yes.
Ray, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great.
Ray, tell us about your van. What inspired you to do this?
Oh, well, me and my partner here, Chris, we're just not fans. We just like to get crazy. So we do stupid things like this just for fun.
Chris, tell me, how long did it take you guys to do this?
It's a couple weeks.
Couple weeks?
Yeah, we turned it into the beautiful van it is.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I love this. Now,
you guys, they didn't believe that I was a Yankee fan because I come from Massachusetts. But I want to point something out for all my friends in Massachusetts. I want you guys to slide down here and tell us what this here is and what this represents. Would you tell us what this represents?
This is history of the Yankees. World championships. Not one, but many.
Something that Boston don't have.